Well, one thing about Disney is the secret is low expectations. I don't know how I screwed this up, but I did. So I thought the park opened at 9 for Animal Kingdom. The plan was to jump in, get Avatar done, rope drop that, then head over to, then get Everest done, and then we've got lunch reservations at Hollywood, so we're gonna park hop. And I don't know how I missed those hours, but as we pulled up in our lift, I'm like, there's a lot of people here. So you adapt, adjust, feel a little guilty, boys are okay. So now we're gonna go wait in line for an hour-ish at at Avatar. And then I did get the multi-park Genie Plus, so we should be able to knock out Animal Kingdom this morning and then head over and get some stuff done at Hollywood. I don't know how I missed that. Double check. In addition to that, I also deleted an entire SD card this morning of filming from yesterday. So I'm really thrilled about that. But hey, can't dwell on our failures. We learn from them. And look, Tree of Life. And Bubbles. Can't be mad when your trash can's blowing bubbles.
Please stand clear of the doors. Por favor, manténganse alejado de las puertas.
Is that crazy or what? I'm not even a huge Avatar fan, but that's ridiculous. Just ridiculous. Still beating myself up. How long am I gonna do this? I've waited in longer lines, but still. Look at this. Rookie mistake. Rope dropping Avatar makes your day so much better. At least the guys aren't too mad at me. And sometimes these little happy accidents work out. You just never know. Disney magic. So we'll see. So, in processing and then synthesizing my mistakes this morning, here's the thing about Disney is, while I say you need to have low expectations, you also need to plan well. And if you plan ahead of time, then you don't have to worry about it as much as a day. Typically when we've come as a family, we prioritize one big deal, you know, whatever we really have to do, and then the rest of it we just let fall in place. But what I should have done, and what you should do, is I should have checked last night park hours again. And I don't think they changed. I think I just screwed it up. But I swear, I mean, I would have bet my life on the fact that it was 9 o'clock this morning. So we were prepared to be here for our extra half hour, which would have been at 7:30. Look how beautiful that is. Hard to be mad when things are that gorgeous. So we would have gotten here, plus we've been off this by now and on to our next thing. And we're a little limited on time because we have 12:20 sci-fi reservations and need to be in the park by 1, I think. I don't know that Rise does individual boarding groups anymore. It might just be a lightning lane, so we may be waiting for that anyway. They change things a lot here, and I really need to do a video on how to ride Rise, because I've said it before, but there's like 6 different ways to get there. So it is 8:15, good morning. We probably got line around, call it 5 till. So 20 minutes we've been in line now. Maybe a little less. So we'll see how long this lasts.
Thank you.
Traveler's log, 2222. Lines moving along. Guys are in good spirits. We are at, call it, half an hour into our perhaps 90 minute wait. We shall see what happens. And sometimes just waiting in line is part of it, right? Sometimes you gotta be in line. And this ride's worth it. Like, I do remember one time we were here and my oldest kid was like, and it was like 2 hours because it was the only way we could ride it. It was night, which I miss Animal Kingdom at night. And then getting off there, like, so worth it. Oh, man. That's beautiful. These guys fill their time with a bunch of games and stuff. Still lamenting, screwing it up. Now I don't look cool in front of the kids. All right, so all in like an hour and a half. Not too shabby. It's 9:40. We've gotten Avatar out of the way. Navi River's down, so that's not an option. So we're heading over to Everest, which is still a 5 minute wait. I did Genie Plus for multiple parks since we're going to park hop. So we're going to, I've got Safari at 10:15, and then Everest is 5 minutes. We'll go hit that and then get back to the Safari and maybe hit Dinosaur on the way out. And that kind of takes care of what we're looking for. At Animal King today. So, look, I know a lot of people say it's a half-day park, and I get it. But it's really all what you make of it, right? Like, there's a lot of walking trails. I mean, this is a different style park. Not a zoo, but it's different than just popping from attraction to attraction. You could really spend some time here. It's beautiful. Again, it's probably... I say again, like I said before, I cannot keep in here, this is crazy, what I'm doing or saying, but it's probably the best theme park. Like, everything here is just so legit, it's unbelievable. So, a lot of 5 minute waits, crowds are good, you know, except for that ride. I think the whole park was literally in line for Avatar, so it'll probably fill up. As we go, I didn't see a standby line for the Safari, which is weird. They change things, you know, if more people watch, hint, nudge, and this starts becoming something I do even on a more frequent basis, then I might be able to adjust to the changes a little better. But it's hard because I feel like every time I come here, there's a different way. So there's no boarding group for Avatar, which there may never have been, but it just gets confusing on trying to figure out. It seems to me like the only boarding groups they have right now are Rise of Resistance, Tron, and why am I at a loss for it? It's right on the tip of my tongue. I'm so stupid. I just did it yesterday. Where was I yesterday?
Second green.
Epcot. Guardians. God, what an idiot. So Guardians and Tron seem to be the only virtual boarding groups. I like the virtual boarding groups. I think it works pretty well. But again, you know, if you come here and don't get it, that sucks, you know, if your whole point. We waited on May the 4th. I waited on Rise and it was like, you know, an hour and a half. It's not bad because the line is the ride. So off to scale Everest. Thank you.
this area,
it's kind of weird. And I, you know, I haven't seen exactly what the answer is to it, but they used to have a really cool water show there and then a night show. And I don't really know what's going on at Animal Kingdom. And maybe I'll try to find out and put in a different video, but I feel like I've done a little bit of research and still can't quite figure out why. They don't stay open later at night. Maybe it's the animals. And why they don't have them in this huge amphitheater. And it was cool. They had kites. And night, they had tons of lights and boats going on. You know, I really enjoyed it. Maybe people don't come. I mean, this is... they're not stupid. There are a lot of
people. There you go.
And even though sometimes they may make a decision I don't love, they typically have a reason. But this just seems like a big waste of space. Oh, look, we're in Nepal. Well, that's going to make some people angry. So they still says 5 minutes on the app, but it's 45. And the cast member just said they haven't updated the website. You don't really, that says 50 on the sign there, but a lot of people use that to plan their time. You pay for GD Plus and it's supposed to recommend things. Look, stuff goes wrong. Gotta roll with the punches. Would have been dope though if it was 5 minutes. So we're gonna try Dinosaur, see if they've got that straight. Get that out of the way, grab a little something to eat. Go do our safari, then maybe get a lightning lane from there. Let's see. Again, I like pretty much everything at Disney. I like Dinosaur. I'm walking over here now to ride it. I think it's cool. But I've always thought it felt like they just kind of ran out of money. And because it, Dino Land, I get it. The idea is you're going to have like, it's like a carnival, and I understand the story and I understand the theming. But I think just because it's so particular, right? It's you already see that. Like it's like a carnival that they painted dinosaurs on. So I've never loved it, even though the rides are fun and the kiddie park was amazing. And Dinosaur the Ride is really good. But I think this area getting a upgrade is much needed and deserved. I think it's going to be great. The rumor is some South America stuff, and they're going to turn Dinosaur into Indiana Jones. Originally, if you're interested, it was a fantasy, going to be dragons and griffins and imaginary things, but I believe it was Eisner who made the decision, had a choice to go dinosaur or fantasy animals, because as you can see, it's still on the sign, but went dinosaur, and it's worked out, but I think it's good time for a change. Walt said, never be finished, right?
Science guys and gals too. They dig up the bones of dinosaurs.
Time travel commencing in...
Get in, grab the Iguanodon, and get out before that asteroid hits. Let's roll!
Computer, what are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
Carnotaurus.
Definitely not our dino. Still not our dino, but at least this one's a vegetarian.
Iguanodon.
Forget it! Get them out now! Brace yourself! This is it! They're not gonna make it! They're not gonna make it!
I mean, that's still pretty good. It'll be good with Indiana Jones on it, but that's still pretty fun. I'll have to look and see what year. We were talking about what year it was made. Because the guys were like, oh, it looks old. And maybe it is, but 80s, 90s? I can't remember. I don't know my park history. And normally I don't film rides. I thought I'd see what I could get, especially since it's going to be gone soon. They're going to do it again. That's how much fun they had. I love it. I like sharing this stuff with people, and yet I simultaneously don't want anyone to come. It's a paradox. Kind of like down by the lake. That's a paradox. So I'm going to go sit and chill. And I think I'm going to look up when this park was made and when Dino Land was made. Because that was, you know, that's some pretty solid technology if it's 30 years old, right? I mean, it still works. They have the Disneyland ride is exactly the same for Indiana Jones, which is why I think they're just going to make a seamless transfer with, you know, a little less effort and money. Because though I want them to do awesome stuff, I get it. They got to make money, man. This doesn't exist. Hey, look, a sunny bench.
The mama and baby Okapi. Now Okapis, despite having the zebra-like coloration on their legs, are actually the closest living relative of a giraffe.
Ooh.
Now across the water, laying down next to the cliff over there, almost looks like a boulder, we got one of the two species of rhinoceros that lives here on the reserve. That is a black rhinoceros.
Hippo!
Hippo's like, this is called a pod or bloat. I prefer bloat. I think it sounds a little bit funnier. It's like they're trying to stay cool in the shade. Pull up a little bit farther, get a closer look. But these guys are oftentimes confused with hyenas, but they're not very closely related to hyenas at all. They're more closely related to, say, domestic dogs or wolves that can live in groups of just the females and their offspring. This is actually only two members of the main herd of elephants that lives here on the reserve. We got a total of about 7 or 8 of them, I believe. That's Mama as well. Judging by the size of this baby, it's going to be around 4 months old, 4.5, maybe 5. It will be growing very, very rapidly in this stage of life. Speaking of water, we've got this watering hole here, one of the elephant's favorite places on the reserve. Not only do you get a drink, but occasionally they'll go swimming. Coming up on the left side, we've got a flock of greater flamingos. Now, they're not called greater flamingos because they're better than other flamingos necessarily, but because they're bigger. Another word you use for a flock of flamingos like this is a flamboyance of flamingos. Now, ostriches, as I'm sure you're aware, are the largest species of bird in the world, but they hold another world record you might not be aware of. Ostriches are the fastest running animal on two legs. They can run in excess of 40 miles an hour, all while only having 2 toes on each foot.
pretty good. Watch that step. All right, I think that's gonna end our Animal Kingdom day. It is almost 12, and we've got 12:20 lunch reservation at Sci-Fi over at Hollywood. So while I was thinking bus, we'll probably take a lift over there to maximize our time. So pretty good day, considering we were like an hour later than I wanted to be. We got Everest is done, and Safari, which I haven't done in a long time, and that was really nice. Got Avatar. It's a good day. Dinosaur, twice. So now just a little stroll out to the parking lot and go check out the blob who creeps and leaps and done, and a delicious cheeseburger. All right, so part one is done. I may cut it here. If I do, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and join me in the, or us, I guess, boys back there, in the next video over at Disney Hollywood.